How is it going, everybody? You're watching Denable Tech, and today I'm going to teach you the most updated and easiest way to install and run Windows 10 on your Mac. And the coolest thing is, this process is 100% free, so everyone can do it. And also, this video is a step-by-step tutorial guide, so I'm going to go through every single step of the process with you, so it's going to be super easy, okay? So without further ado, let's begin. Okay guys, so the first step to install Windows 10 on our Mac right here is to actually download Windows 10 itself. So download the operating system itself, the ISO file. And to download it, it's super easy. You just go to this website right here, which is Microsoft website, but I'm gonna have the link in the description, of course, to this exact page, okay? So you just click there and you're gonna go to this exact screen. And then right here, we can download Windows 10 disk image ISO file, as you guys can see right there. So it's 100% free, legit, don't worry about piracy or anything like that. All you have to do is scroll down a little bit and you're gonna see select edition. Just click here, select Windows 10, and then click on confirm. And then it's gonna say validating your request, and then product language, again, tap on it, and then English, and then confirm once again. Validating your request, and then last but not least, you gotta check the version. If it is a 64-bit download or a 32-bit download, pretty much all Macs now are 64-bit, only the older ones are 32. If you're not 100% sure if your Mac is 32 or 64, just click on the Apple logo and then about this Mac right there, and then check here after Intel Core, right here at Core on after processor, if it says Core Dual. If it says Core Dual, then you got a 32-bit Mac. If it says Core i5, i3, i7, i9, or any other variation, you got a 64. Again, only older Macs are 32-bit, okay? So after that, just go ahead, in my case, 64, of course. And then it's gonna start downloading automatically. As you guys can see, it's super easy, super instantaneous, and it's done. Of course, you gotta wait for the download to finish. I already have that finished, so I can cancel that download because I don't need that anymore. So I can close that screen as well. And then after we have the ISO file, we are pretty much good to go, and we can pretty much start the installation process. But before we do that, we just need to see if we meet some criteria, okay? We need to see if we meet some requirements. They are not a few, they are not a lot, it's just a few requirements, but we need to check if we meet them, okay? First of them is storage. You need to have some storage if you want to install Windows on your Mac, of course. You're installing another operating system on top of Mac. So we need to get at least 50 to 55 gigs of free storage. If you don't know how to check that, again, Apple logo, about this Mac, and then you're going to go to storage. And for example, I have 55.44, roughly 55 gigs. That's enough, that's what you need. If you have less than that, less than 50, I would recommend you start deleting stuff in order to install Windows on your Mac, okay? And last but not least, you have to check if your Mac, what Mac version your computer is running. So what Mac OS version. If it is running El Capitan or newer, so like El Capitan, Sierra, High Sierra, Mojave, Catalina, or later, you're good. The process is gonna be super easy. But if you're in Yosemite or later, so older than that, then it could be a little bit more complicated. So, and you actually need to get a thumb drive, so a flash drive of at least 16 gigs, a blank 16 gigs flash drive in order to install. So have that in hand if you have, if your Mac is older and you're running Yosemite or older, okay? Keep that in mind as well. So with all those things done, now we can actually get started. It's actually not a lot, was it? So, and of course we're gonna need to use the software to install Windows on our Mac. So as you know, we have the ISO file right here. I'm gonna put it in the desktop, so it is right there. But this is Windows. We need to get a software to install it. And what software we're gonna use? We're actually gonna use Bootcamp. So I'm gonna explain why I chose to use Bootcamp. I think this is the best software right now to install Windows on your Mac because of performance, okay? If you use a virtual machine like VirtualBox or Parallels or anything like that, it is actually gonna run Windows on top of your Mac. So we're gonna have both operating systems working at the same time, and that makes both systems very, very slow, okay? I have methods here on my channel showing how to use with Bootcamp, but if you wanna game, if you wanna use heavy software, a specific software for Windows, I recommend that you use Bootcamp because you're gonna have much more
performance with Bootcamp, okay? So just use Bootcamp, trust me, all right? So without further ado, let's begin. So go ahead and continue. And now we're gonna choose the partition, okay? So how many gigs you wanna have your macOS or your Windows to share. So for example, right here on this example, it's very, very small letters. So, but as you can see, Bootcamp is suggesting that I get 92 gigs for my macOS, 29 for my Windows, and then 10 gigs free. I like that suggestion, but of course I can click here and I can readjust, but I'm gonna keep with that. And then it is asking me to select the ISO image, the file, Windows itself that we have just downloaded, right? So click on choose, and then as you know, it is on my desktop. So I'm just going to click desktop and then tap on it and then open, and then it's right there. Okay, so then go ahead and install. And then as you guys can see, it is downloading Windows support software. And so you get remaining download time. It's still calculating, so it's going to show me in a second. Now Bootcamp is telling me I'm not connected to a power source, but I got like over 90% of battery and my Mac is new. So I'm saying continue on battery power. Okay, keep in mind, you should have internet connection. Okay, it's important that you are connected to internet, because for example, it is downloading Windows support right now, so we need internet connection to do that. So now let's wait. I'll be back when it's done. Now it's saying partitioning disk. Okay, so now let's wait. As I said, this is a step-by-step tutorial guide. So then I'm gonna show you every single step of the operation of installing Windows 10 on your Mac. Okay, so I'm gonna go through all those steps, and of course I'm gonna be cutting, because there's no point you waiting while like progress bars and load bars and things like that. Okay, so leave the computer as it is. It's doing its thing. If you see the battery is running low, connect to the power source, because you need the computer to be on all the time. Don't let it restart or turn off, because you will have problems, okay? So now let's wait for the next step. Next step is saying copying Windows files. Again, let's keep waiting. Saving Windows files. And then now it is saying that it is saving Windows support software. Let's keep waiting. It's almost at the end now. Just be a little patient. And after that, a pop-up will come up saying that Bootcamp Assistant wants to make changes. So then, like, you can use password right here and type it, or you can, like, put your fingerprint on Touch ID if your computer is compatible. If not, just type your password normally. And then, as you guys are seeing, it is automatically restarting your Mac. Okay, so it's just closing out everything. As you know, every time you want to use Bootcamp, it actually logs off of Mac and then logs in into Windows. Okay, so that's the process. That's how it does. It logs off and then it logs on. So as you guys can see, just logged off of Mac, and now it's logging in into Windows. You can't have both operating systems at the same time. No, it turns off one and then turns on the other. So you gotta be you gotta have that in mind. As I said, this will guarantee you a lot more performance. Okay, this is much better for you. Trust me, it's much better to run every single operating system like independently, okay, and individually, instead of having them both at the same time. Okay, now it is the Windows setup, and then I'm gonna go through that very quickly, as I did as well with the installation. Okay, so just let's go ahead and get started. So language, English, time and currency, format, that's all done. So hit next, okay, right here, next. And then here, the activate Windows. A lot of people get confused here. They think you need to get a key or a serial key or something like that, a product key. You don't. All you have to do is to click here. It's very hidden. I don't have a product key, so click here. If tap doesn't work, just click, okay, with the mouse, okay, sometimes with the trackpad. Sometimes tapping doesn't work, you have to actually force and click, right? Now you choose the option, so you can choose Windows 10 Home or Pro or whatever you wanna go. I'm gonna go with Windows 10 Pro and then hit next. Mouse is very sensitive, the trackpad is very sensitive here on Windows. I can change that later in settings. So I accept the terms, next. And now it is installing Windows itself. So it's gonna copy Windows files, getting files ready, install features, install updates, and finish up. Okay, this is gonna take a few minutes maybe, so I'm gonna cut that until that's done, until it's on finishing up, okay, and I'll be back. Okay, it has finished, and now it is saying that Windows needs to restart, so it's gonna automatically do that. So as you can see, it is normally restarting. You have to keep in mind that you don't need to press anything right here, so just let it do its thing, okay? You don't need to press anything, don't need to, please don't restart the computer, don't turn off the computer, don't do anything. Just let Windows do its thing and let Windows automatically install their operating system here on your Mac with Bootcamp, okay? When that's done, I'll be back. And after it restarts, of course, you have to manually input some information as well, of course. So region where you are, so United States, for example, and then a few more things about keyboard and other things. So US keyboard, no skip. I'm gonna do this as fast as I can, but of course showing you everything. So connect to a network. Let's connect to my router here in the studio. So connect. Put the passcode, just a second. Okay, now we're connected, so hit next. And then just a moment, and then it has more important setup to do. As you know, setting up Windows is a lot more complicated than setting up your Mac, but that's, if you need Windows, you need Windows, so you gotta put up with that, right? Now we need to select if it's for personal use or organization. I'm gonna say personal, of course, it's much easier. So next, and then we're gonna sign in with Microsoft. I don't have it, so I'm gonna say offline account. I truly don't have a Microsoft account, sorry. And then it's gonna sign in to da 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 da, and then I'm gonna say limited experience, so without Microsoft apps and services, okay? Who's going to use this computer? I'm gonna put my name, of course, so I'm just gonna put here Daniel. Sorry for my iPhone in front of the screen. Hit next. And then a super memorable password. Let's do this. And then confirm it, of course. And then security questions. You gotta be patient, right? So I'm gonna do that and I'll be back in a second. So then again, it's saying just a moment, and I don't wanna do that. So get help from digital assistant. That's Cortana. I'm gonna have Cortana because why not? Maybe there's some content here. Now we have choose privacy settings, and there's quite a lot of privacy settings here. I'm gonna leave it as it is, okay, just to make it quicker. So accept. And then let's see what Windows throws at us next. Apparently nothing. So hi. It's gonna say it's setting up some things, getting ready and all. So again, we have to be patient. It says it may take several minutes, so I trust Windows when it says it's taking a lot of time. So let's wait. And we're done. Yeah. So the first thing you see is Microsoft Edge. Okay, you can say get started here, and then that's their browser. Okay, that's Windows browser. As you know, you can close that. I don't need that right now. And then it's actually saying that welcome to Bootcamp installer, and we actually need to go through that last single step in order for Bootcamp to install all the drivers and servers and things like that, just to make it updated. Okay, so click next, accept. And then install, and then it's gonna do that automatically, okay? As I said, this is important to install all drivers and everything that Windows needs to run properly, okay? So we have that loading part as well. Don't skip that, and wait a second, and I'll be back again. It is done, so now we can finish, and it is automatically gonna restart, okay? Because now it's done. Now it has actually installed everything. So after it restarts, we're actually gonna get Windows perfect, full Windows ready for us to use, and as I said, with perfect performance. And there you have it, it's restarted, so we can actually put my passcode, and then Windows is saying welcome, and it should open in a second. As you guys can see, perfect. So I like Bootcamp, first of all, because it looks very much better with Bootcamp instead of VirtualBox, where you get black bars or something. It is just 100% optimized for your Mac. This is the best Windows experience you can get pretty much ever. It's gonna run Windows much better than most Windows machines, and of course it's gonna run Windows much better than virtual machines like VirtualBox and Parallels, as I mentioned. So it is working, it is fine. As you guys can see, it is super responsive. You gotta keep in mind that you always have to click, not actually tap on the trackpad in order for it to work. But as you guys can see, everything is fully functional. You get all the messages, you get Wi-Fi, you get all your sounds, your battery status, everything, absolutely everything. Okay, so last but not least, now that you know that you have full Windows working right here on your Mac, how do you actually go back to Mac? Because as I told you, every time you're using Windows, your Mac operating system is off, is shut down. So you cannot go back while you're here. You have to shut down Windows and then go back to Mac. And you have to do that every single time. So you log off, you shut down of one operating system to go to the other. So it is running independently, Windows or Mac. It's not running at the same time, and this is great for performance, okay? So you're gonna tap here on this little arrow and then tap tap on the bootcamp icon, and then I'm going to say restart in Mac OS. So tap here, and then okay. So then what it would do is it'll actually shut down your Mac, your Windows, and then go back to your Mac. That's it. It is as easy as that. And then, as you guys can see, it is shutting down. And then now you see the Apple logo. You're going to boot it up normally on your Mac OS machine. And last but not least, of course, how do you get back to Windows? How do you open Bootcamp again? You don't actually go ahead and click on the Bootcamp icon right here, because this is the assistant to install it, to set it up and install. Actually, you just have to click on the Apple logo and then restart. And then as soon as you press restart, press on the option key. So option or alt key, okay? So, and then restart, and then press on the option key while you do that. And then of course, you're gonna see that it's gonna open in a different way. So then instead of just regularly restarting, it is actually gonna get you a different screen. I'm still pressing the option key, by the way. So it's appearing the Apple logo, as you guys can see right there. And then it's gonna say you can release now. And then it's gonna say Windows or Macintosh HD. So then you just select. As I said, you gotta understand that it is almost as if you have two computers in one. Now I have two computers in one. I have Macintosh HD and I have Windows. You choose which one you wanna start up from, and then you just click on it, click on the Windows right here, and then it's gonna open up on Windows. So now I have two computers in one, and I can't use them simultaneously, only individually, and this is great for performance. Okay guys, so that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Now you can run perfectly Windows 10 on your Mac for free, the best way you can do it, the easiest way to set up, and the best way regarding performance as well.